있어요. 죄송합니다. 감사합니다. Okay, it's his newest video, Cake. After this, I'm going to check out the other half of the album because essentially there's six tracks with Bet on Me, None of My Business, and Cake, all having music videos. So then there's three other tracks that I, as far as I know, they don't have videos yet anyway. So I may just go ahead and check out those other three tracks and complete the album review for it. But it's looking very sort of candy cane peppermint, kind of, with the color scheme that's going on here, this red and white. And then it's called Cake, so let's check it out. Whenever you see the crown, you know that's the conclusion of the ITZY video. It's definitely very summery. The album is, you know, has this well, I mean, None of My Business, very summer type of themed, right? This is a little more upbeat. It's a little brighter, right? I really enjoyed a lot of the melodies in the vocal lines, especially we have two kind of bridge sections. The first one, that, you know, the song starts out in four, but when your first sort of bridge section comes around, there's a very evident change to a three count, right? We switch it up to sort of a triplet, very dance-like rhythm. And then there's another sort of change up in the progression for the second bridge. Interesting changes up, change ups in the mix as well. Some instrumental changes to kind of really emphasize the contrast between what these sections are and what they have going on. I think this, I want to see the performance video or the dance video, you know what I mean? Because the choreography is actually very fun. It's interesting. I was watching the documentary for the making of this album, right? And there's what they really were kind of working on was like finding the right songs that they thought were good enough. I guess they have the writers, at JYP that were coming up with certain ideas for certain songs, and some of them they just weren't into. They just didn't really like. So these songs are the ones, barring any sort of complete rewrites or from scratch sort of efforts after that, because I haven't. There's been two episodes of the documentary, and it seems like there's going to be more. I mean, the way it kind of concluded the second episode, it seemed like it's leading to a continuation of it. So I'll have to wait to find out more about that for sure. But the songs all seem to be going for this sort of summer type of vibe. At least None of My Business and Now Cake. Bet on Me seems more like it's very positive. It's very sort of empowering, but it has a bit of a different vibe to it. It's very cool. Like it's a very cool track, whereas these None of My Business is very warm. There's a little bit of heat in that track, and then this is it's very bright, right? It's the color, both in the visual and in the music. This is all very bright. It's like, everything's very shiny. It's as if you're in the sun. I love the bass sound on this. It's very fun. It's very deep, very big, very round, almost bouncy. There's like a little bit of bounce to it, right? And the way most of the rhythms going on in the mix are pretty consistent, like they're pretty straightforward, and this is what gives the space for a lot of the vocal lines to have these really interesting sort of rhythmic patterns to it. And of course, when the chorus comes back around, it's a fairly consistent type of rhythm that's going on for that section. Most of the chorus, well, it emphasizes the eighth note subdivision for sure. That's the one and two ands, and then, but there's fun little triplet groupings, fun little change up 16th note patterns that are going on across this track, like in the verse sections. Candles, a cake, right? So see the cake, 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 cake. One and two and three. I think it's one and two and three, four, yeah, no, one eight and two and three, right? It's a piece of, right? That's 16th notes. And then once we get to the la 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 la. So triplets, right? One lolly, two lolly, three lolly. So they're already playing with these. With all these different subdivisions, right? And all these different sort of patterns. Chaeryeong's, why aren't more people talking about Cher Young's high note, right? She really does have a fantastic upper register, you know, those when she goes for the high notes, it's always got this wonderful sound to it. It's a lot of it's like I would call it dense, like the pitch, of course, the frequency is getting tighter, it's getting narrower, right, as you move up, but it's so strong in the middle of that, right? It was a beautiful ascending line right there, and see this wonderful bounce, right? Boom, tss, boom, tss, boom, boom. It's a bit of a throwback type of a beat too. So there's a little hint of nostalgia within what the bass is doing. Ryujin, what is this? You know, you had she covered for you, right? Who, so you know, whoever this is, this is funny. This is a like, there's a bit of self-awareness in this humor here. You know what I mean? But well, you know, I would, that's not good marksmanship, right? Like you know, she didn't really line up her shot or anything, so it's not surprising. Like that's actually pretty good. I would expect it to be like out here somewhere, you know, like thank goodness it didn't go left, right? It didn't go high and left, it went low and right. But she was there to cover for you too. Ryujin, actually, she's done really well over like I mean, none of my business. Like she was all over that track, you know what I mean? She's got a pretty good part and presence in this track as well. She's doing a lot of work, man. She's doing a lot of work on this album. Wait a minute, who fell? I couldn't keep track of that. Oh, Leah. See, there's some self-awareness in this video. Like these things that are kind of chaotic and going on, they're kind of having a go at themselves also. I want to appreciate that for what it is, right? This is pretty funny. So that was the build up, right? The sort of pre-chorus section, there was a lot more synth parts that came to fill out the rhythm there. I was distracted by Leah's plunge onto that little truck or whatever it is. But there was definitely a much bigger synth sound to fill out the rhythm section. And it kind of subsides a little bit, right? Moving into this main chorus part. We have there's little instrumental piece parts in here that come in to do these little motifs, these little rhythmic patterns that are going on, and it kind of changes up each time. So the, you know, on that part right there, boom, tss, boom, boom, tss, boom, boom, tss, boom. If you pay attention to the mix, the lowest parts, we have the percussion and the bass, and then that rhythm part over it. They're very line, like they are almost the same pattern throughout, like essentially the same rhythmic pattern. And then there's a couple of little plug-in voicings in there that are doing some other patterns, maybe filling in some of the other spaces within like each measure, right? But the most intricate part is the vocal parts, like throughout, right? Except for the chorus, right? But even then, it's just a very concise type of rhythm that is the same each time in the vocal part. But what you have is a layering, right? Like you have a very, shall we say, like a wide, expansive sort of bass sound that's going on. And then over that, the rhythm part starts to line up with it as well. And then at the top, or over that, you have some of the other, a couple of little plug-in sounds here and there. You might hear some instrument sort of positioned over, like panned right, a little bit higher above everything else. But the vocal then is all over the top, right? With the most contrasting rhythmic patterns. So the song is basically structured like a cake, right? Like a cake has these different layers to it. And the bottom, right, you have like the bass, that's your main cake part, the actual cake, the bready soft cake. And then you have the rhythm part over it, which starts to line up. And that might be, sometimes you have one of those like cakes where you got chocolate and then you got the cream cake, right, over it, like so. But it's the same thing. It's a nice, soft, fluffy, full sort of texture, right, that's on there. And then there's the icing, right? The little, that first layer of like frosting or whatever that goes over the cake. And then the vocals are the actual, icing where they put the little frills around it and the little designs on it and everything and create like a picture or something like that over the top. But the song is called Cake, and it's very much the song structure is layered like a cake. The color change here, all the bass drops out, the percussion, and there's this guitar. So it's a very clean guitar that has a little bit of, well, actually quite a bit of reverb on it. It almost sounds like there's one of those, like an octave chorus type of effect, kind of, but there's it's spread out so much, right? There's like, 'cause there are these very very almost like wonky sort of tinny type of string sounds that I hear them mostly right, but it doesn't seem like where the attack is as these chords are being played. So it seems like a bit of an effect to kind of produce those tones in a part of a as a chorus effect, like to what's actually being played or where the normal clean sound of the guitar actually sits at. And so what is it, we've created a lot of space here, like a lot of open space within the mix, and Taeryeong is doing her, melodic, very very smooth, and but it's very nice. I love it whenever she sings her parts, because it's like I think a very underrated vocal quality, right? Like this the sound that she makes is always enjoyable. Like it just always sounds so good. And this part does feel like very cool, right? It's very light, it's very loose, it's very like free. She does a good job of bringing out that type of feeling in this part of the song. And let's see. The crowd. It's a fun song. It's a fun video. There's you know, there's a lot of wacky ideas that are going on here, but I can appreciate the self-awareness in the humor and some of these different bits that, you know, the Ryojin missing that shot and Leah falling from the rafters. It's funny, you know, like they're not afraid to take shots at themselves also. And the whole idea is like, you know, this it doesn't matter, they're just having fun, like they're just gonna keep on doing it. And you know, it's fun, it's a very fun song. It's got that summer type of feeling to it. It's very bright, it's very, you know, sort of, it's got a throwback rhythm and sound in the bass part for sure. So that's kind of like perhaps remembering, you know, or that memories of summer, you know what I mean, like whenever you sort of think of summer, right? And everybody's got like these fun experiences that they can recall from, you know, taking a summer break from school or going on vacation or, you know, doing all these different things. This song structure is like a cake. It's layered in a very specific way. Like it every section sort of adheres to this for the most part, with a little bit of like the biggest change up is actually that second bridge part, because we get a drop in the low end of the mix almost entirely. Like that's all high mids to uppers, you know, in that sort of second bridge part. But it's a fun song throughout, man. It put a smile on your face, man. This, you know what I mean, this is it's they're having fun with this one, and that's good. I'm glad that they chose some songs that they really, you know, felt good about and wanted to have fun with. And because it's a very self-aware video, and like it certainly is, you know, it's funny. But Ryojin is just putting in a lot of work on this. I mean, everybody's, you know, got their parts or whatever, but I'm just, between None of My Business and this, now this video, Cake, I feel like Bet on Me was Yeji's, you know what I mean? Like there's she just, to me, has like the biggest presence in that song and video, even though it's actually fairly evenly distributed. It's mainly the visuals, right? But in these most recent two tracks, I mean, Ryojin's all over, man. She's got like different parts, and you know, she covers the spread between the rapping sections and sung sections. She actually is doing really well. Like she's doing some really good, wonderful vocal work on these songs, man. And there's really fun melodies, fun rhythms in the vocal parts for Cake. It's the icing on top, man. It really is. Like it's a sweet, rich, very bright type of song, you know. It's if you have like, if you have a summer birthday, you know what I mean, like it's fun like that. It's fun like a summer birthday party, you know what I mean. It's it's a good time. It's a wacky video, man. Like there's some moments in here where I was like, what in the world? But again, like this sort of self-aware humor that's in it. I enjoyed it, man. I enjoyed it. I'm all about it. I think they did a good job with this one. Itsy Cake. It's a fun time, man. It's a fun time. It's a fun, super summery type of song. And I think it actually contrasts really, really well with the Bet on Me and None of My Business tracks too. Provides another sort of color palette against what those songs kind of have going on. And it's fun. It's a fun time, man. Cake. It's good.